In this screencast, we're going to talk about what's known as a Moody chart, which relates a frictional factor, losses considered in pipe flow and other systems, to that of the Reynolds number and the relative roughness. This is the Moody chart. You can see that it's a log-log based scale with two y-axes and an x-axis. On the x-axis, we have the Reynolds number. On the right y-axis, we have the relative roughness. And the relative roughness is indicated with each of the black lines that you see. So for instance, if we had calculated relative roughness of 0.001, we would follow along this line to whatever our Reynolds number was. Then we would go to the left and determine what our frictional factor would be. Now this is different depending on the type of flow. If we have laminar flow, we're working only in this region over here. And we know that the relationship for the frictional factor and laminar flow is just 64 divided by the Reynolds number, which indicates that it is a linear relationship, and that's exactly what you see here on the left. Now, when we work with turbulent flow systems, we start moving to this right and using all of the lines indicated as such. There are two lines specifically that we need to mention. One, that being a smooth pipe. So whenever we say we assume smooth pipe flow, we would use this bottom line. And this dotted line is for when we have wholly turbulent flow. And the relative roughness is how we're going to calculate our frictional factor. Let's go through an example on how to read this plot. So here in the first example, we're told that we have a Reynolds number of 2 times 10 to the 5th for water through 1,000 feet of piping that has an inner diameter of 3 inches. We're asked to figure out what the major losses are. So when we think about major losses, we'll write HL as our head loss. And we're going to say that that's equal to the frictional factor times the length of pipe over the diameter times our velocity over 2g. This is something you typically see in a fluid mechanics type problem. And what we're most interested in is this frictional factor, since probably given the velocity, or that's something we could back calculate from the Reynolds number, knowing that we could look up the information for water, we're told the length and the diameter, so we could calculate the losses. Let's just focus on the frictional factor. We need two pieces of information to use the Moody chart and calculate the frictional factor. One is the relative roughness. Now we'd have to look up the roughness of whatever piping system we're using. And as you can see on the left, we have a chart where we pulled up this information. Let's assume somewhere in the middle, so we're going to go ahead and say 0.01 feet, and this is over our diameter, which is 3 inches. So 3 inches over 12 inches per foot is going to give us 0.25 feet. This gives us a relative roughness of 0.04. The other piece of information we would need is the Reynolds number, which we're given as 2 times 10 to the 5th. But let's look at our Moody chart. Given that we're at 0.04, we're pretty high in the Moody chart, we're somewhere along this line, and a Reynolds number of 2 times 10 to the 5th, which we could see right here, we'll follow up this line in along our relative roughness line, and then we'll read what our frictional factor is on the left side of this chart. And you can see we're somewhere between 0.06 and 0.07, a little on the higher side. So we would estimate that our frictional factor is 0.066. We would use that below in our calculation for our losses, and then determine some other condition of our system based on this information. Now if we take a look at this system, it's important to realize that with this kind of roughness, the Reynolds number really doesn't have much of an effect in a certain range, probably from right about here to as high as 10 to the 8th. So the roughness plays a very significant role in affecting the frictional factor, whereas the Reynolds number, not so much. And you can see that at lower frictional factors, the Reynolds number does play a higher role, but there are still regions where the lines are straight, and increasing the Reynolds number would not increase the frictional factor. Now that's not the case for laminar flow, and we can see that in an example. But we have a Reynolds number of 1,000 for glycerol through 50 feet of cast iron, given an inner diameter of 4 inches. We're asked to calculate the losses associated with this. So again, we calculate our relative roughness. So in this case, our roughness for cast iron is 0.00085 over 0.33. Since we're working with feet, this comes out to 0.0025. Our Reynolds number is again given to us in our problem, which is 1,000. So we go up to our Moody chart. For 1,000, we're going to be somewhere right along this line. And you can see that our roughness actually doesn't play a factor in this. And that all that matters, since we're in laminar flow, is that we calculate it either by reading it off the chart, or to be a little bit more accurate, we could say that the frictional factor is equal to 64 divided by the Reynolds number. So we read 0.066. We could also calculate it by 64 divided by 1,000. This gives us a frictional factor of 0.064. So pretty close to how we read it. So hopefully this gives you a good idea on how to read a Moody chart.